curve eclipsing even the English longbow in popularity. But where did this bow come from? According to modern scholarship, this bow is the Scythian bow. It was used by most steppe nomads. The Assyrians were said to have transferred this bow in exchange for horses.
2,000 years before the Hun threatened Rome, steppe people sold horses to the Assyrians for their war chariots. The Assyrian war machine needed horses in quantities only the steppe could provide. Assyria, the charioteer's weapon, the composite or recurve bow.
If that's true, then why are steppe horses too small to pull chariots? So, where did the Assyrians really get the horses big enough and fast enough to pull their war chariots? And what about the bow? The Assyrians were only interested in recruiting the best units. They made an alliance with the Scythians. They also traded with other empires of steppe warriors, along with the Nubians. This is the Assyrian bow. This is the Nubian bow. The Assyrians, after their defeat, by the Nubians in the Levant, traded for Nubian horses, bows, and soldiers from Nubia. Later, the Persians used Nubian mercenaries.
Nor is your king a righteous man, for were he such, he would not have coveted any country other than his own, nor would he now try to enslave men who have done him no wrong. Now, give him this book. And this message the king of the Ethiopians counsels the king of the Persians, when the Persians can draw a bow of this greatness as easily as I do. Then to bring overwhelming odds to attack the long-lived Ethiopians, but till then, to thank the gods who put it not in the minds of the sons of the Ethiopians to win more territory than they have.
Why did the Nubian king say a bow of this size? People interpret this as size as in length, but I think it was actually draw weight. You can tell from the following story, where the bow is taken to Persia and all the archers gathered to try to string the bow and draw the bow. None were able to do it, not even Scythians and Medes, who were excellent archers and also in close proximity to the Persians and also in their army. The true inventor of the so-called Turkish Scythian bow was none other than Nimrod. We can tell that this is true because the astrological sign Sagittarius is a centaur. This sign was used by the ancient to commemorate the first horse archer, Nimrod. Nimrod was the son of Cush. Cush was the father of the Nubians. Nimrod used the Nubian bow. What was the shape and length of the Nubian bow? Well, let me tell you, it's not like this. The Nubian bow was 48 inches of lamented horn reinforced terror. From paintings and inscriptions, we can see that the Nubian bow was short and curvy, much like the short curvy Korean bow. The usage is also similar. The only reason to make a short, powerful bow is for horse archery.
Delay not day or night, but I have had a game of chess, fight at side. Force battle from deep distance. Yoke the war horses. Draw up the lines of battle. Amun is the god who has sent us. He makes the weak strong, so that a multitude flees before the feeble, and one man takes a thousand captive.
The Nubian bow and the Nubian archer was used extensively throughout history, especially the Nubian horse archer.
Go, swift messengers, to a people tall and smooth-skinned, to a people feared far and wide, an aggressive nation of strange speech, whose land is divided by rivers. All you people of the world, at that time gifts will be brought to the Lord Almighty from a people tall and smooth-skinned, from a people feared far and wide, an aggressive nation of strange speech, whose land is divided by rivers.